Hello, everyone. My name is Michael Wigman, and I'm one of the co-organizers of the Cul-de-sac Print Exchange. And in this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about the print that I created for the exchange, as well as my in-home studio practice. Unfortunately, we won't be able to see any physical prints getting done because of the stay-at-home order and the fact that the Columbus Printed Art Center is currently closed for the time being. But nevertheless, I'll still be able to give you some information about how I create my imagery and talk a little bit about the processing that it requires for it to become a plate or for it to become a screen layer or things of that sort. For a little bit of professional information about myself, I've taught printmaking for several years, most recently at Ohio State University, where I was not only teaching many of the print courses, but also was the shop technician over there. So I have experience in all forms of printmaking. But currently, right now, I'm working at Upright Press, where I'm one of the dudes over there, and we work on a lot of different forms of screen printing, like gig posters and t-shirts. But not only that, we have a lot of experience working with different artists, not only here in Columbus, but both nationally and internationally. So we're able to see a lot of really cool illustrations that we turn into screen print layers and really push the process to its fullest. For the print that I did for the Cul-de-sac Print Exchange, I utilized two processes. One of them was screen printing, which is the layers underneath. The other one was the photopolymer plate process, which was utilizing a KM plate, which I'll show a little bit later on in the video. As far as the conceptual imagery in the piece, it's about city planning. So the figures at the bottom of the print all have their heads down and they have these speech bubbles either coming out of their eyes or their mouth or their whole face. And those elements are utilizing the communication source, showing that the figures are fully invested in this, visually invested in this, or speaking about ideas as opposed to not seeing, you know, what could be potentially on the horizon. Below that in the speech bubble, there's all these roads and things kind of crossing together, which is constructing this city environment. Now through that process though, they're ignoring what's happening above, which is what's actually happening in the world. So the speech bubbles are not focusing on that, but above them there's all these sirens and megaphones and things like that that are cascading down all this information, but yet the figures are oblivious to it because they're focused on their environment that they're creating. So they're creating this environment of a narrow-minded cul-de-sac and avoiding what's above them. And that process can later lead to some issues that cause social issues, political issues, things like that. So that's kind of what that piece is about in a nutshell. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the camera around and we're going to look at my studio space back here and we'll talk a little bit about my process in making the photopolymer plates, as well as look at a little bit of screen layer action that I have in here as well. So let's turn around. All right, let's move into the studio tour. To begin, let's look at my screen print process a little bit. So with screen printing, I typically start on a sheet of design vellum. This is one right over here. Design vellum is slightly transparent, so I'm able to maybe work up collage or something like that underneath it. But then I drape this over the top and then work with Micron pens and Prismacolors to draw up that image. This will get scanned into the computer, and then from there I'll live trace it to allow it to be digitized enough to work up other layers in Photoshop and Illustrator. Here's a couple other examples down there. For this particular drawing, this became a poster for the band Torch that did a show at Ace of Cups back in November. You can see it right over here. But you can see that mark making that I had on the design vellum, how it kind of translates through the digital process to become the poster. Over here, we have some sheets of drafting film I've worked on over the years. And these are what I use to create my KM plates, which is the photogravure process I was talking about earlier on in the video. The drafting film is transparent, but it has a little bit of texture, which is able to accept pigment from things like Prismacolor pencils, which are what I use with the process. So you want to be using black Prismacolor, which I got some black Prismacolor pencils right over here. So you're able to create an opaque image. So if you use something like an ebony pencil or something like that, it looks gray, which is then kind of harder to tell how it'll get exposed. When these are exposed onto KM plates with an aquatint screen, the areas of the image that are opaque will hold ink, on the plate, similar to what you would get out of a aquatint on a copper plate. If you want to learn a little bit more about this process, I'm planning on doing a workshop at the Columbus Printed Art Center when it opens back up. But this is kind of just a general idea of how I work through the process, at least the early stages. This is the KM plate that formed after I was done working on this drawing on the drafting film. So you can see up close, it's got all these little crevices and stuff in there, which is just like aquatint. So it's basically able to be inked up just like a copper plate would be after it's completed. And the results, I think, look pretty great. This is kind of a leftover print I have from a separate image, but it still is the KM plate process. And you can see how that ink kind of lays down on the paper and kind of really translates that drawing pretty effectively from what I did on the drafting film earlier on. I also have some examples here too of multiple color printing. So this is a two plate KM plate. These are really great to kind of work up with multiple color printing because with them being transparent, you're able to see kind of how things are going to layer up later on. The only thing that I try to do is I try to butt up the corners at a 90 degree angle and make sure that these are slightly larger than the plate I'll be exposing onto. So then when I go to expose them, I butt them up into the corner right over here, expose them onto the plates. And then when I get to the printing press, I kind of create a registration jig to be able to get the crisp registration I'm looking for. So similar to what you would do in multiple color intaglio. So yeah, it's kind of a very quick description of what I do in this space right over here. It's a little barren at the moment. This used to be filled with prints and things like that because my wife is currently working from home. She's a psychologist, so she meets with a lot of her clients, and she needs to have a room that is quiet. So my studio space doubles as my studio and her office at the moment. And she can't have scary prints behind her, so she gets the barren wall. I still, though, have a Bearded What print right over here and a Michael Barnes lithograph right over here, though. So those weren't removed from the space. Also got a Peloton. That is not mine. But whatever. Anyway, though, thanks for visiting, and I hope you enjoy the rest of these videos. Talk soon.